Well, I don't know what Mother Nature's deal was the past 4 days, but if I didn't know any better, I'd say she was trying to blow herself all off the planet. Yeah. Luckily, I weigh a lot, I stick to the ground, and ain't nobody blowing me off this planet. Today is flight day for Tango 1. Look at how pretty it turned out. Now, if you don't follow me on Instagram, you should. I'll put my link down there, unless it's already there. Then I don't have to put it in there. So what? Shush. My antenna just came loose. Hang on. I know. Sounds like a personal problem. At the flying rodeo, the Rodeo 110, when Tango 1 was a Rodeo 110, I decided, you know what? Time for that puppy to grow up. There's not much you can do about it when it's not a frame. This is a QAV-130. It gained a whole 20 centimeters or millimeters or something like that. I don't know. I don't do metrics. It's America, goddammit. We do inches and feet. I like it. So I'm going to quickly go through the build here. There are pictures on my Instagram if you want to see some of the things of the process of putting it together. But real quick, I have to look. Yes, these are Emax 1306 motors. These are Raycorp 3-inch props. I think they're 3030s or something like that. I only got them because they were the right color, so there's that. We're running the Microlux F4 8K, 8K, and I think I'm running multi-shot on it. The only reason I'm not running a D-shot or anything like that is because the Cicada 10 amp, volume, the Cicada 10 amp 4-in-1, I think if I read it right, has some kind of special process to enable it. And then, you know what? I don't want to go through that. It flies, right? I really like this frame, but this is a knockoff from the QAV-130mm. I think this is made by Maker or sold by Maker on Amazon. I got it because it was the right size. And it was 20 bucks. So, you know, there's that. Now, I was going to do this review yesterday, and I was flying around having a good old time over at International Drone Day. And lo and behold, one of the props caught the wires for the camera and they were coming out right here. So as you can see, what I did was I took a piece of red tape, because I'm fashionable like that, wrapped it around the top to make sure no wires fall out into the propellers. And you can see it goes all the way around. The other thing that I should mention about this, and I'll put a picture up here, I have this soft mounted on a Catalyst Works. It's in the picture. I'm sure the title is right there in the picture. And that allows for the lessening of vibrations. And I think it's very important, especially when you get down to these small ones, to try and reduce vibrations as much as you can. And that's what we're doing here. Now, there is also a 3D printed file for this thing, not made by Catalyst, but by someone else, that you could probably go out and print your own if you had that accessibility. Otherwise, you can buy it from Catalyst, and the link will be down below. This is not a sponsored video. I just felt like that was a really good idea. We're gonna fly it and have a little fun. It's gonna run a 3S battery, not a 4S, and that's largely because I have the lights from the rodeo on here. And as you can see for the build, maybe if I move that strap, you could see it. Unless some of you people have your X-ray glasses on, you're looking at me naked. Some of you do. I know what's going on. Don't, not blind. All right, here's the Catalyst soft mount right here. This is a Cicada. This is the Microlux F4. Then the Tramp HV is over here. And then down in here is where the light controllers are. Now, let me tell you, again, these lights were not made for something this small. So it's out over here, so I had a real tight fit, and there's no way I would have gotten a like a Palulu or a some kind of stepper to step up the floor for the light. So I'll always have to stick with a 3S on this aircraft. We also went ahead and went to the Runcam Mini Swift, and we'll take a look at that on a separate review, but for right now, just know that's what that orange thing is in the middle, messing up my color scheme. So just like the rodeo, the lights are on, and I put the lights underneath the feet here to protect them, and then we got our blinkies in the back. Let's fly. We'll be right back. So I really love this setup. I love the Microlux F4, mini F4. I know a lot of people gave it a bad rap online, but I believe that was the one that included the receiver. Right now I'm running the XM Plus in here, like I run on all my other ones. And it flies like a dream. It's running an 8K, 8K loop. Everything is sharp and quick. I have to tune it up a little bit. That's you know, a given. When you first put one together, I went with my old settings with the rodeo, and sometimes they apply, sometimes they don't. So we'll have to just mess around with a couple things and get it a little bit crisper. I also love this Run Cam Mini Swift, but we'll do a review on that later. But it was a beautiful picture coming out of this thing, one that I have not seen yet on almost on any camera except a couple of the AKK cameras. I like those. They gave me a really good shot. But running 600 milliwatt and one of these, you can't go wrong. Even at 200 milliwatts, this camera performs stellar. This antenna, I think, is really helping boost things too. This is the Lumineer. Can't see without my glasses. AX2? Lumineer AX2, whatever it is, I'm gonna put it down there. But I just picked these up on eBay. They have a very good axle ratio. It's also very small and nice for something like this, where you don't have that big globe sitting out. So that's the way to go with one of those. There you go, my QAV 130 call sign Tango 1. But for the time being, I gotta get out of this park because someone just told me, hey, you can't fly those things here. And what the heck, I know other places I can fly, so I'm out of here. From a beautiful day with the least amount of wind we've had all week, which would stop me from doing videos, in a beautiful park somewhere where they're not gonna let me fly anymore. This is the Mighty Four. Remember, don't buy it until I try it. See ya!